Guinevere and Lancelot walked in the garden of the abbey where Guinevere had lived ever since King Arthur was mortally wounded at the Battle of Camlann and taken away to the land of Avalon. The two walked side by side. It would be the last time the two lovers would meet in this lifetime. But as they walked, their history unfolded before them like a medieval tapestry, rich and full of story. Guinevere's father had been an ally of King Arthur's, but her marriage was not simply a matter of political expediency. Arthur was young, handsome, brave, and strong, and dedicated to bringing England together under one ruler. Arthur ruled in Camelot. Guinevere sat at his side, loving him as a queen and as his wife. Sir Lancelot had been raised by the Lady of the Lake, taught the skills that a knight needed to know, how to wield a sword, how to set a spear, how to ride, how to give mercy. He was taught the courtesies and courtly manners that a knight needed to know as well. And when he arrived at Camelot, he was soon acknowledged to be the greatest knight of the company of the Round Table. But his greatest strength was his loyalty to his lord, King Arthur. Together they fought many battles, subduing villains and bringing peace and order to England. In those days, knights of the Round Table would often become the champion for a lady of the court, and Lancelot became Guinevere's champion. He would wear a ribbon or a scarf or a ring as a token of her favor when he fought a duel or in a jousting tournament or in battle. But after a while, it wasn't enough to be her champion. The two of them fell in love with each other, and they were torn between their loyalty to King Arthur and the overwhelming passion they felt for each other. On a number of occasions, Lancelot rescued Guinevere. Once she was held by a knight in a castle, and the only way to get into the castle was to crawl across a bridge constructed of upturned swords. Lancelot did just that, slicing the skin on his hands and his feet in order to save her. Another time, he was in pursuit of someone who had kidnapped her. His horse was killed from under him, and Lancelot followed her, riding in a cart. Although that was considered ignoble for a knight, Lancelot didn't care. All he wanted to do was to make the greatest haste possible in order to save Guinevere. But each time Lancelot rescued her, he always returned her to her husband, King Arthur. For 9 years, Lancelot and Guinevere were lovers, meeting when they could, but the other members of the court soon became suspicious. They saw the lingering gazes, the whispered conversations. Their love affair was a secret only to King Arthur. Eventually, Lancelot and Guinevere's love was revealed to King Arthur by members of the court. Lancelot was forced to flee Camelot, and Guinevere was sentenced to burn for her treason. But before she could be dragged to the fire, Lancelot returned with his knights, saved her, took her to his castle. It was the beginning of the end of the golden era of the Round Table. Former comrades took up arms against each other, took sides against each other. Plotting and treachery became the order of the day. King Arthur besieged Lancelot in his castle. After a battle, Lancelot and Arthur made peace. The terms of the truce between them meant that Guinevere would return to King Arthur. Lancelot went to France, but King Arthur returned to Camelot to face the treachery of his nephew, Sir Mordred, who aspired to be king. They fought a battle, and though King Arthur killed Sir Mordred, he also received a mortal blow. As Arthur lay dying, he asked that his sword Excalibur be thrown into the lake, and when that was accomplished, the ladies of the lake came in a barge and carried him off to the mystic land of Avalon, from whence he may someday return to unify and bring peace to England once again. After the battle, Guinevere made her way to the abbey at Almesbury. She dedicated her life to prayer and service. Lancelot had tried to get back to England from France in time to help King Arthur, but he was too late. He heard where Guinevere had gone and went to visit her at the abbey. Guinevere and Lancelot walked through the garden together, through the flowers and the herbs. Birds were singing in the trees, and their memories shone between them. Memories of Camelot, the glory days, the tournaments, the feasts, the celebrations, the jousts, the pageantry, and their hours of passion and their days of deceit. The nights Lancelot lay alone, wishing, the nights Guinevere lay weeping next to King Arthur, who slept unaware. As time came for him to leave, Lancelot fell to the feet of Guinevere. Tears streaming from his eyes, he begged for her forgiveness, for the pain, for the passion that he could not overcome, but she lifted him up. Tears flowed from her eyes as well. She asked for his forgiveness, and they gazed deeply into each other's souls in a clear-eyed moment of mutual absolution. "You must not come again," she said, and Lancelot felt his heart break like the cracking of a crystal goblet. Lancelot took Guinevere's face in his hands, kissed her on the forehead, and turned to leave. He looked back one time from the gate and saw Guinevere sitting on the bench, the slanted light of afternoon on her face as the shadows lengthened. Lancelot took up residence at a hermitage near Glastonbury and dedicated his life to prayer and atoning for the evil things he had done. For many years, he lived there, joined sometimes by former knights of the Round Table. But one night, he had a dream, a vision in which Guinevere called to him. The next morning, he got on his horse. He rode as quickly as he could to Almesbury, but arrived too late. Guinevere had died only an hour before he arrived. He brought her body to Glastonbury, buried her in a marble coffin, sang the funeral service over her, and lowered her into the ground in a place that no one knows now. But Lancelot did not live long himself. Within a few weeks, he felt himself growing weak, and one night he passed away in his sleep. His brother, Sir Hector, stood over Lancelot's body, holding his sword and his shield. He said, "Ah, Lancelot, there you lie. I dare say you were never matched by any earthly knight's hands. You are the most courteous knight that ever bore a shield, the truest friend to thy lover, the truest lover of a sinful man that ever loved woman, and you are the kindest man that ever struck with sword, the goodliest person that ever came among the press of knights. You are the meekest and the gentlest that ever ate in the hall among ladies, and you are the sternest knight to your mortal foe that ever put spear in rest." Lancelot was buried in a place that no one remembers. Let the singers sing and the poets tell how a kingdom rose and a kingdom fell, how love ran cold and love ran hot in the halls of Camelot. Say their names and shed a tear for Arthur, Lancelot, and Guinevere.